Right guys, welcome back to the channel. I've got to do that little clap thing. This is my badass Mark III Transit, 1990. As you can see, for a 30-year-old van, it's quite straight. I'm really pleased with it. I spent the past 2 years looking for a Mark III Transit van, and I went and looked at a lot of snotters for more money than I paid for this, and they were rough. It is, as they say, slammed, but it's lowered properly. It's got a set of custom made front springs with the pigtails left in, so they sit in the cup properly, and on the back it's got a custom set of like leaf springs, so in a flipped axle job it drives really well. The wheels are Mark 6 banded. They didn't come, like, it came with them wheels, but they were rough as a bear's ass. So I had them powder coated and redone. I put brand new wheel nuts in and 4 brand new tyres. So if you can see those fellas. And I know I mostly do bikes, but this is one of my fleet, and I thought, you know, it's cool enough to put on the channel. I love old Fords, but I'm a realist. They're shit. I think they're absolutely gangster. Cozzies, Mark 2s, Series 3s, they're all the bollocks. But, you know, they're shit. They rust. So yeah, rust is a big issue, obviously, with Fords. Well, with Japanese, in my old Delica was a rot box. It's just the country we live in. It's got too much moisture in it. But I spent 2 years looking for a straight, clean Transit, and I'll show you this, look. And this will shock you. Look, inside there. I mean, there's a couple of scabs. Look at the sill light. See if I can get it down or not. Look at that. No patches, no repairs. And then inside here, original steps, original arches. Let me show you the other side. All original steps. All the back of the bed. All the original bed, original arches, original doors. I've spent the best part of 2-3 years. All of the doors, lovely and mint. All back. Look at that. Excuse me. Yeah, for a 30-year-old Transit, it don't get much better than this. I mean, I've seen stuff that was 20 years newer than this. It was absolute scrap. The story with this goes is, it was used by some engineering firm or something like that, and it got nicked, but only lightly stolen. They broke the column and some other bits, and then it just sat in a warehouse, and that's how it survived. It's only been on the road a year, starting this January. The guy I bought it off had put it on the road, didn't like it, or no, I think the story went, he just spent 2 years nut and bolt restoring an old Cortina. He drove it and said he fucking hated it, and it what was he saying? What was his holy word? He said it ruined his life or something along them lines. He said, oh yeah, it was heartbreaking. It was his dream car, and then he said he got this that he was going to like obviously get to absolutely pristine, and just went, I've had enough of it, and got rid of everything. So right, what's cool about it? Lowered, obviously. 2 litre Pinto, so we've got Pinto power. A couple of bits I've done. I need to get for it are this side seat cover, because it's cracked. I need to get a lower cowling for a Mark III, and I need a door pocket for that side. But look at the interior in this. All the bolsters, all the seats, and this ain't on here hiding a disaster. This is mint as well. I've just put that on there because I'm a filthy bastard, and I need to try and keep this as mint as possible. Original head deck didn't work when I got it. I took it apart, cleaned out the inside, and I soldered the connector inside the board, and now that works. So you want to hear that, don't you? Let me get the keys. Let's see if we're still playing. Yeah, we're still playing. So, right.
That's as much as you're allowed due to copyright. I tell you what is cool. I've got a 2.8 Capri steering wheel in it. These do not fit transit. It's got the correct spline, but on a transit column, there's two of the splines that are a double pin, and you have to cut and key away the steering wheel to get it fit, but it looks absolutely dope. If you look at this from the dash, it just looks correct, like it should be there, and it looks so much better than the standard wheel. As cool as the standard wheel is, and it was cool because I've still got it, this looks pocker. Right, I'll show you in the engine bay. And it is just as cherry in here. Let me get you on your crutch, man. Okay. And there it is, in all its glory. The Pinto powerhouse. Inner chassis, inner legs. Got a, like some sort of, you know, Mark II Escort branch manifold on it. It's got a some sort of twin choke Weber off a Capri, he says. In there, dirty, but no rot, as you can see. Look down in there, all original skirtle panel. And yeah, and to be fair, it's probably the fastest thing I own out of all the monkey bikes and everything else. I'll fire it up for you now. I actually thought I was gonna hate the Pinto. Actually, I do hate them with a passion. I say I hate them with a passion, I think they're overrated. I think they're overrated, but Ford stuff is a bit rose-tinted glasses, to be honest, and I do love them, but at the same time, like I said, I'm a bit of a realist. Should we do a sound check? Yeah, my original plan was to try and get an auto sleeper version with a pop top and then convert it, and I was going to take the Pinto out and put my Volvo V230 FT, which I've still got in the stand in my garage. I was going to put an M90H behind that, but then this runs great. I'm quite happy with it, to be honest. I'm just going to run this for a season as it is and then decide what I'm going to do. Follow me on the YouTube, and if you want to see some more of the transit, let me know. Give me a comment, let me know if you want to see some more of the transit on the channel. I'll probably doing the engine swapping it at the end of the year. Going to be looking for a 350 bhp 8 valve red block. This is the Moisey V230 FT. This is the motor that was powering my drift car for a good couple of years, about 3 or 4 or 5 years, I think it was, maybe even more than that. I think I've probably had this engine in some sort of carnation turbo and in one of my cars at least for the last 10 years, and this makes strong power all day, every day, loves it. And I just can't bring myself to put it in anything else. So, you know, I want to have it in a camper van. I don't know how cool it'd be to have a 300 bhp transit van. So I know, you know, some people might hate the idea of, you know, putting a Volvo motor in a Ford, but my mates put one of these in a Cortina and it was good laughing, and my mates put a couple in different other stuff and they've always worked out quite well. So I thought I'd just quickly show you this. Obviously it's got a 28, it's got a cam in it, it's got a tubular manifold, it's got a TTV racing flywheel, it's got a full chipped set of ECUs and a few other stuff. So it's not a box standard engine, this makes good power out of the box. So yeah, it's a good solid motor, and I don't know what I'm going to do with it. It might end up in Neymar. I'd love a YB, but you know, who's really realistically going to drop $7,000 into just an engine and harness for it to make 205 horsepower? Because as cool as it would be to pop that bonnet and see that fucking lovely Cosworth rocker cover on the top of there, it's just not going to happen. So, just, you know, bear with me. It might happen, it might not. I might end up changing my mind, but this is where we're at the minute. So yeah, that's it. That's my new transit. And I thought I'd post on the channel, like I say, one of the guys messaged me and said, you're going to put your transit on the current channel. I was like, to be honest, it's not really about vans. But I don't know. I thought I'd post it up anyway. I thought you guys would find it cool. And if you want to see more of the transit, I'm going to recap it all the back. I've got some stuff that's like, you know, that kid's roadmap where you put toy cars down. I've got to have all of it carpeted. My mate's a carpet fitter, so he's going to do that with like some nice thick lino and that, so at least we can use it as day van. And then when I want to put motorbikes and all the dirty stuff in there, I'm going to pull it out in one piece. Because if you spill, I was going to board it, but if you spill petrol onto board, it doesn't come out. And then you're smelling it, and you won't enjoy driving it. And then I thought, you know what? What I need is somewhere I can brake clean and wipe it down, and then if I need to, you know, I want to sleep in it for a car show, or you know, I can just put some 12 volt sockets in it and we're good to go. You know, cool box, some beers and a barbecue, and you're camping, ain't you? As always, you know, guys, I appreciate the people that do like and subscribe to my channel, and ciao for now.